It's July 16, 2017. Game of Thrones Season 7 went live, and people all around the world have logged in to see the show live, which ended the HBO site crashed. This turned into millions of disappointing tweets from the GOT fans. Website crashes and performance issues have always been disrupting the online space. What is performance testing? To know more, stay with me to understand the what, why, and how of performance testing and watch the full video. Welcome to our channel, Little's Law, and I'm Vasant. I have 10 plus years of performance testing experience. Do join me. First, let's see what is performance testing. You might see a lot of graphs and charts in the performance test reports or whenever someone talks about performance of an application. But what exactly is performance testing? Performance testing is a non-functional software testing technique that determines how the stability, speed, scalability, and responsiveness of an application holds up under a given workload. Now we understood what is performance testing. Let's now move to goals. What are the goals of performance testing and what do we want to achieve at the end of performance testing? First, throughput. The metric that indicates the number of transactions per second an application can handle. The amount of transactions produced over time during a test. For every application, there are lots of users performing lots of different requests. What you need to ensure is that your application meets that capacity before it hits production or live. The second metric is response times. Response times refers to the amount of time the application server takes to return the results of a request to the user. The response time is affected by factors such as network bandwidth, number of users, number and type of requests submitted, and average think time. Finally, it is critical to detail the performance specifications, that is, the performance requirements, and document them in the performance test plan. Now, let's move to the next important area. Why performance testing? Firstly, to determine whether the application satisfies performance requirements. Say for example, to understand whether the system can handle up to 1000 concurrent users. Secondly, to locate the bottlenecks within an application like CPU utilization, memory utilization, and network utilization. Thirdly, to validate whether the application is able to achieve its SLA claimed by the developer. Fourthly, to compare the system with its previous version and to confirm how best the latest version performs. And next is to measure the stability of the application at their peak traffic or peak anticipated load. So far, you have seen why performance testing. Let's now see how to do performance testing. The performance testing steps or process varies from one organization to another and one application to another. Also, it depends on the performance indicators the business considers the most important. Though the process or steps differ everywhere, the general goal of performance testing are largely the same and the test plan is followed everywhere. Next comes identifying the test environment and the tools. The environment should be mostly the pre-production environment, which should be a replica of production its configuration. Next comes the tools. Since we are emulating a huge workload and it needs a lot of effort, so it can be achieved only by tools. We will discuss about various tools in our coming videos. The testing process continues with documenting the hardware, software, infrastructure, and the configuration involved in testing. Next comes planning and designing. First, we have to create the test scenarios that accommodate all the critical use cases. The test has to be designed accordingly and outline the metrics that should be captured during the performance testing. Next is preparing the test environment and the tools. We have to configure and keep the test environments ready before we execute the performance tests. Identify and assemble the right testing tools. So now we are ready to run the performance tests. First, execute the test with the planned workload and workload distribution in the identified environment. Secondly, capture and monitor the metrics during the testing. What should the performance testers do if we identify any performance bottlenecks? We have to consolidate and analyze the test results. Share the findings with the project team, which is very important to get the issues fixed. Fine-tune the application by resolving the performance shortcomings identified. Once the issues are fixed, the test has to be repeated to confirm that each problem has been eliminated from the application. Yes, performance testing is a never-ending process. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe for more videos. Please like the video, share it with your friends, and comment your inputs. Thank you so much.